Hey, what's going on? Today we're going to cover a very simple way to figure out which foods are healthy and which foods are not. Let's do it.
Everywhere you look these days, there's conflicting advice. One day food is terrible for you, the next day it's fine, the next day it's terrible again.
Honestly, who can keep up with this stuff?
Not most of us. According to a survey of 2,000 consumers, almost 80% of people are confused by health and nutrition messages.
The truth is, a lot of that confusion stems from advice that is just not scientific. At the end of the day, this stuff doesn't need to be so complicated. Food can be simple. What a concept. So today we're gonna play a very simple game. We're gonna compare two common foods and we're gonna see how they square up. We're gonna call this food battles. Or maybe we should call it food fights. It's a little too on the nose. Or, you know what we could do? We could call it Hunger Games, because it's basically two foods that are... Anyway. All right, let's start our little investigation by looking at eggs. Very common food and very misunderstood. So let's just pull out Old Faithful over here and let's see what we can find.
But before we start, here's the question of the day. What contains more iron, eggs or lentils? We'll find out in a minute. And no, it's not a tie. There is a clear winner. Okay, back to our food battle. Let's start with a simple Google search. And right on the search page, without needing to visit a link, we have on the right side here this nutritional information table. And so we see that for one egg, weighs about 50 grams, has 78 calories, 5 grams of fat, 187 mg of cholesterol, etc., etc. So let's compare it to lentils, for example. Obviously, you can do this with any foods you like. This is just an exercise. And we go to the nutritional information on the right. Let's put them side by side so it's easier to compare. 100 grams of each. And there are some big differences. Fat, for example, 11 grams in eggs and only 0.4 in lentils, and so on down the list.
Okay, but what do all these numbers actually mean?
We need something to use as reference. The USDA's latest dietary guidelines recommend a diet low in saturated fat, mainly due to the risks of heart disease. And they go on to specify people should eat as little dietary cholesterol as possible. And finally, both the USDA and the American Heart Association have recommended a minimum of 25 to 30 grams of fiber per day, whereas Americans on average eat only half that amount. There are other parameters as well in the recommendations, but for now, we'll keep it simple and stick to these main ones. So we're shooting for low saturated fat, low cholesterol, and a solid amount of fiber.
Okay, now that we have a solid scoring system, let's take another look at our food battle.
Obviously, eggs are very high in fat, and if we look only at saturated fat, the difference is even more striking. 33 times more saturated fat in eggs. So lentils win that round easily. Cholesterol is pretty clear too. Eggs are extremely high in cholesterol, whereas lentils have zero. That's another easy one. And finally, fiber. 8 grams in lentils and 0 in eggs. So just going by the USDA guidelines, it's pretty much a landslide for lentils. Another interesting thing here, protein, they both have a substantial amount, a bit more on the eggs, but lots of protein in both. Beyond these main guidelines, if we look at micronutrients, there are some differences. For example, eggs have vitamin D and B12, lentils don't. And iron, interestingly, although we tend to associate iron with animal products, we find there's 3 times more iron in lentils. So that's the answer to our question of the day.
All right, so what did we learn from all this? Well, it seems pretty clear from the comparison that lentils are a very healthy food, covering pretty much every requirement of the USDA daily recommendations. Eggs, on the other hand, look comparatively pretty unhealthy. You do get the vitamin D and the vitamin B12, but you pay a very heavy price with all the cholesterol and all the saturated fat. Before we wrap up, I just want to add, the point of all this is not to tell people what they can and cannot eat. We're just learning about food with a very simple technique that empowers you to make whatever choices you deem best.
What I personally do is I avoid eggs as much as possible and I eat lentils as much as possible. And I make sure to get my vitamin D and B12 elsewhere. So that's what I've decided to do for myself based on what I've learned.
The take-home message here is that with a quick search on your smartphone, you can get a pretty decent idea of the nutritional content of a food and the health value of a food, so that shopping and eating doesn't have to be this black box thing where we have no idea what's in the food and we have no clue what's going to happen to our health if we eat A, B, or C. If this technique seems super simple to you, that's because it is. And that's exactly why it's so powerful. I mean, it's just a Google search, right? Duh. But the truth is, I've learned more about nutrition from doing this consistently over the last 5 years than from all of med school and all of grad school combined. And that's not an exaggeration. So give it a shot. This technique has been huge for me. It has taught me a lot about nutrition, and I think it can help you as well. And I'll see you on the next video.